Bandon, Oregon. Bandon is a city in Coos County, Oregon, United States, on the south side of the mouth of the Coquille River. It was named by George Bennet, an Irish peer, who settled nearby in 1873 and named the town after Bandon in Ireland, his hometown. The population was 3,066 at the 2010 census. Before 1850, the Coquille Indians lived in the area. Then in 1851, gold was discovered at nearby Whiskey Run Beach by French Canadian trappers, though the gold rush did not have much of an impact on the area. In 1852, Henry Baldwin, from County Cork, Ireland, was shipwrecked on the Coos Bay and walked into this area. The first permanent European settlers came in 1853 and established the present town site. In 1856, the first conflicts with Indigenous Americans in the United States arose and those were sent to the Siletz Reservation. In 1859, the boat Twin Sisters sailed into the Coquille River and opened the outlet for all inland produce and resources. Bandon was founded by the Irish peer George Bennet in 1873. George Bennet, his sons Joseph and George Seely came from Bandon, Ireland. The following year the town's previous name of Averill was changed to Bandon after the town of the same name in Ireland. The next year, Joseph Williams and his three sons arrived, also from Bandon, Ireland. In 1877, the post office was established. In 1880, cheesemaking began. That same year, Congress appropriated money to build the jetty. In 1883, the first sawmill, schoolhouse, and Catholic church were built. In 1884, the U.S. Army Corps of Engineers began construction on the jetty. Cranberries have been grown in Bandon since 1885, when Charles McFarland planted vines he brought from Massachusetts. McFarland had originally come to pan for gold in California. He did not make his fortune, or even a living, so he turned to what he knew best. He brought vines from Cape Cod and planted them in the state's first cranberry bog near Hauser. This bog produced cranberries for 8 decades. His variety adapted to growing conditions on the West Coast. The variety was named McFarlane in his honor and was the principal variety grown on the West Coast until overtaken by the Stevens variety. Bandon is also the location of the first cranberry bogs to be wet harvested, which is done by building dikes around bogs then flooding them. In 2010, Bandon was named one of the coolest small towns in America by Budget Travel. On September 26, 1936, a fire burned several miles of forest east of town. But a sudden shift in the wind drove the flames swiftly westward. Ignited by the forest fire, the town's abundant gorse became engulfed in flames, Bandon resident D.H. Woomer told the Coos Bay Times. Bandon's entire commercial district was destroyed. The total loss stated at the time was $3 million, with 11 fatalities. Ironically, the gorse was first introduced to the Oregon coast by the founder of Bandon, Lord George Bennet, from his native Ireland. Firefighters found that burning gorse reacted to having water squirted on it like a kitchen grease fire. It simply spread burning gobs of gorse everywhere. Stuart Holbrook described this conflagration in his essay The Gorse of Bandon. Part of the commercial district had been erected on wooden pilings jutting out over the Coquille River not far from the south jetty, accommodating river traffic at the merchant stores. After the 1936 fire, when Bandon began to be rebuilt, the new perimeter of the business district did not extend beyond the available land. There is still gorse in Bandon today, but municipal codes strictly regulate how high and thick it may be allowed to get. According to the United States Census Bureau, the city has a total area of which, is land and is water. Bandon has a marine West Coast Mediterranean climate, Köppen CSB. Rain and overcast conditions are common in the winter months, while during the summer it is mostly dry. Snow can occur during the winter, however, this is not very common and usually occurs about once or twice a season. Below freezing temperatures are rare in the city, usually occurring about once or twice a winter. Extreme temperatures of or colder are extremely rare, usually happening about once every 5 years. Summers are dry and cool with an average July high temperature of above, while lows are generally in the 50s degrees F. High temperatures in the mid-70s degree Fahrenheit to the low 90s degree Fahrenheit occur on average about once or twice every 3 or 4 years. Bandon's highest reading of occurred on September 21, 1990. The lowest reading of was observed only 3 months later on December 21, 1990. As of the census of 2010, there were 3,066 people, 1,466 households, and 762 families residing in the city. The population density was. There were 1,860 housing units at an average density of. The racial makeup of the city was 92.6% white, 0.4% African American, 1.4% Native American, 0.8% Asian, 0.1% Pacific Islander, 1.4% from other races, and 3.4% from two or more races. Hispanic or Latino of any race were 5.5% of the population. There were 1,466 households, of which 18.1% had children under the age of 18 living with them, 37.6% were married couples living together, 10.2% had a female householder with no husband present, 4.2% had a male householder with no wife present, and 48.0% were non-families. 39.6% of all households were made up of individuals and 20.8% had someone living alone who was 65 years of age or older. The average household size was 2.01 and the average family size was 2.62. The median age in the city was 53.4 years. 15.3% of residents were under the age of 18, 6.3% were between the ages of 18 and 24, 17.3% were from 25 to 44. 31.2% were from 45 to 64, and 30% were 65 years of age or older. The gender makeup of the city was 46.3% male and 53.7% female. As of the census of 2000, there were 2,833 people, 1,287 households, and 736 families residing in the city. The population density was 1,029.4 people per square mile, 397.8 per square kilometer. There were 1,535 housing units at an average density of 557.8 per square mile, 215.5 per square kilometer. The racial makeup of the city was 92.48% white, 0.25% African American, 1.94% Native American, 0.60% Asian, 0.11% Pacific Islander, 0.95% from other races, and 3.67% from two or more races. Hispanic or Latino of any race were 2.75% of the population. There were 1,287 households, out of which 21.2% had children under the age of 18 living with them, 43.4% were married couples living together, 10.1% had a female householder with no husband present, and 42.8% were non-families. 36.1% of all households were made up of individuals and 19.0% had someone living alone who was 65 years of age or older. The average household size was 2.09 and the average family size was 2.71. In the city, the population dispersal was 19.1% under the age of 18, 4.7% from 18 to 24, 19.4% from 25 to 44, 27.5% from 45 to 64, and 29.4% who were 65 years of age or older. The median age was 49 years. For every 100 females, there were 82.4 males. For every 100 females age 18 and over, there were 80.0 males. The median income for a household in the city was $29,492, and the median income for a family was $37,188. Males had a median income of $28,636 versus $22,722 for females. The per capita income for the city was $20,051. About 11.9% of families and 16.0% of the population were below the poverty line, including 34.1% of those under age 18 and 6.0% of those age 65 or over. Like many communities on the Oregon coast, Bandon had significant fishing and timber industries, which were greatly diminished by the 1980s, though some remnants still exist. Bandon's current economy revolves around wood products, fishing, tourism, and agriculture. The five largest employers in the area include Bandon Dunes Golf Course, Southern Coos Health District, School District #54C, Oregon Overseas Timber, and Hardin Optical. In tourism literature, the city is often referred to as Bandon by the Sea. Surf enthusiasts come to Bandon for surfing and kite surfing. Bandon beaches offer a wide variety of surf opportunities for novice, intermediate, and expert surfers of both disciplines. Crowds are non-existent and locals are friendly and accommodating. Mountain bikers enjoy the newly opened Whiskey Run mountain bike trails just north of town. Mountain biking. One popular tourist activity is storm watching. West Coast Game Park Safari is located just south of Bandon. Bandon is a center of cranberry production. More than 100 growers harvest about around Bandon, raising 95% of Oregon's cranberries, and about 5% of the national crop. Production averages about 30 million pounds, 14 million kilogram, of berries. Harvest is in the fall. In 1994, were harvested, a record for Bandon. Some berries are trucked to Eugene and Albany. Others are taken to an ocean spray facility in Prosser, Washington, to be concentrated. This crop was introduced in 1855 by Charles McFarlane, for whom the McFarlane hybrid is named. The annual Cranberry Festival takes place in the second weekend of September to celebrate the cranberry harvest. The event draws tourists and participants from all areas of the Oregon coast, Washington, and California. Begun in 1946, to honor the cranberry industry, 2016 will mark the 70th year of the event. Bandon has long been known as the cranberry capital of Oregon. Between 1928 and 2000, dairy production and cheesemaking were an integral part of Bandon's economy. The Bandon facility was damaged by fire in 1936, and rebuilt as the Surfside Dairy in 1937. In 2000, Tillamook County Creamery Association bought the Bandon cheese brand and promptly dismantled the factory. On October 4, 2005, the last of the staff was released and the Bandon factory closed. The Bandon cheese name lives on as a brand of Tillamook cheese. In 2013, Face Rock Creamery opened on the former Bandon cheese property with participation of the city government. Cheesemakers handcraft gourmet cheeses from beginning to end with viewing, sampling, and products available to visitors. There is a selection of flavored cheese curds which one cheese critic received favorably. Funnily, the lead cheesemaker for Face Rock Creamery is the son of lead cheesemaker from Bandon Cheese Factory. Bandon Dunes Golf Resort is a complex of five golf courses located just north of the city of Bandon. Four of the five golf courses are regulation length and the other is a short 13-hole par 3 course. The championship courses, Bandon Dunes, Old MacDonald, Pacific Dunes, and Bandon Trails are the top four courses in Oregon. Passove, J., Golf Magazine, Top 100 Courses You Can Play, September, 2016, p. 62. It is noteworthy that French writer Jules Verne, in his science fiction novel The Begum's Fortune, placed on virtually the precise site of Bandon his fictional utopian community Ville, France. The fictional community was given the foundation date of 1872, 1 year before the foundation of the actual Bandon. Ville, France was depicted as being founded by Dr. Sarajan, a visionary French doctor, reaching a population of 100,000 within a few years of its creation and becoming world famous as a model community, being granted by the U.S. government the status of a virtually independent city-state, and being involved in a vicious war with a rival city-state on the other side of the Cascades, founded by an evil German scientist. Bandon has one sister city. Thanks for watching. Don't forget like the video and don't forget to subscribe.